Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Data Logic with Shivam. I am back with one more Power BI interview question which can be asked in your next interview. So before moving forward, I would request you to subscribe my channel and like my videos. This will really motivate me to create such content in future. Let's move to Power BI. So the question is, find out what different tasks each employee has completed. So I'm having two tables. The first one is employee table, Chris, John, Ross, and the other one is the task which is completed by these employees on a particular date. Like if you can see, Chris has performed task 2 couple of times, John has performed task 1, task 3, and Ross has performed task 1, task 2, task 3 couple of times. So in output, we wanted to see what are the different tasks each employee has completed using Power Query. So I'll move to transform data. What I will do first, I will merge my employee table with daily log table so that I will get the task name according to the employee name, right? So I'll go to merge query and merge query as new. I will select this from the employee table, and then from the daily log I will select the employee name column here, and I will keep the left outer join because I wanted the task to be here beside my employee name column into my employee table, right? So I'll go ahead and click on OK. Now if you see here, I got tables in each of the employee. I'll expand it and I'll keep only task because I am interested into the task itself only. Now if you can see here, in this data we already have the duplicates also. So in order to have the different task of each employee, I need to first remove the duplicates. If you see here, if I go ahead and short this data, if you see here, Chris has performed task 2 couple of times. This is a duplicate. Then Ross has performed task 3 couple of times. So that is why we need to remove the duplicate also. Otherwise, if we will group the data, it will, this duplicate log or task will also come. So I'll remove this step and then go back to the previous step, and then I'll select the column and then I'll remove the duplicates. So once I remove the duplicates, it will be only pending with the employee name and the task which are not duplicate. Now what I will do, I will group by the name, employee name. I'll click on the group by, then I'll give the name as combine, and then in operation I don't have a option to concatenate, right? I wanted to concatenate, if you see here, I wanted to concatenate the task, right? For example, in John I should have task 1, task 3, in Chris I should have only task 2, and for Ross I should have task 3, task 2 and task 1. So in order to get this in concatenation, I don't have any Power Query from here in group by to concatenate the values. So what I will do, I will give the name combine. I will select here the sum, and then I'll select the column which I wanted to do the concatenation, then I'll click on OK. So definitely it will give error. Now in order to concatenate, there is a function in Power Query which is called text.combine, and since I need delimiter also, so I'll add comma as a delimiter and then I'll click on OK. Now we have the required data For John, we will have task 1, task 3, Chris, task 2, and then Ross, task 3, task 2, and task 1. I'll close and apply. We will match our output with the output here. Now I'll add the table in order to match my data and the previous data, so that we will confirm we are getting the required output. I'll take the employee name and the combine. Now you can see here, let me increase the font size. Now you can see here we are getting the required output also. Task 2, Chris for task 2, and then John, task 1, task 3, and Ross, task 3, task 2, task 1. So I hope you like this video and you practice this scenario. If you know any other solution for this question, then please write down into the comments. I'll check, and I will again request you to subscribe my channel and like my videos. I'll meet you in next video. Thanks.